Now and then, a fossil is found that tells an amazing story, and I've been lucky to be involved in one such story as part of a research team that has described a unique fossil in China. It presents a moment in time that shows a carnivorous mammal locked in mortal combat with a larger plant-eating dinosaur, with both lives suddenly ended by the effects of a catastrophic volcanic mudslide. This amazingly well-preserved fossil was discovered in 2012 by scientists in China, where it resides at the Weihai Zigong Xiyan School Museum. The fossil dates to the early Cretaceous, about 125 million years ago, and it's the first such fossil of its kind, with actual evidence of predatory behavior on the part of the mammal, rarely seen in the fossil record. The fossil comes from a site in northeastern China dubbed China's Dinosaur Pompeii. The name refers to the many well-preserved fossils of dinosaurs, small mammals, lizards, and amphibians in the area. And, just as in Pompeii, many of the animals are thought to have died suddenly en masse. It was the result of one or more volcanic eruptions and the ensuing volcanic mudslide. The dinosaur in this fossil, preserved on its belly, is Cetacosaurus. It's similar to this one in the Canadian Museum of Nature's collections. Cetacosaurus is an example of an early horned dinosaur and lived in Asia during the early Cretaceous. It was a small plant eater about the size of a big dog. The mammal we described in the fossil pair is a badger-like animal called Rapina mammus. Although it wasn't large by dinosaur standards, it was among the largest mammals from the age of the dinosaurs. We know this carnivore preyed on certain dinosaurs, including Cetacosaurus, because paleontologists have found baby bones of this herbivore in the stomachs of Rapina mammus fossils. So the coexistence of these two animals is not new. What is new is shown in this fossil. The dinosaur is lying prone with its hind limbs folded on either side of its body. The body of the mammal coils to the right and sits atop the dinosaur. The Rapina mammus is gripping the jaw of the larger Cetacosaurus. The mammal is also biting into some of the ribs. And the back foot of Rapina mammus is gripping onto the dinosaur's hind leg. So they were intimately intertwined, and the evidence suggests an active attack was underway, which was suddenly interrupted by the volcanic mudslide that buried them. My colleagues and I ruled out the possibility that the mammal was simply scavenging a dead dinosaur. The bones of the dinosaur have no tooth marks, for example, suggesting it was not being scavenged, but rather was being preyed upon. And it's unlikely the two would have become so entangled were the dinosaur dead before the mammal came upon it. The position of the mammal over top of the dinosaur suggests that it was also the aggressor. Although it's uncommon for a predator to attack prey much larger than itself, it does happen occasionally today. Some lone wolverines are known to occasionally hunt animals many times their own size, including caribou and domestic sheep. And on the African savanna, wild dogs, jackals, and hyenas will occasionally attack prey that are still alive, with the prey collapsing, often in a state of shock. This might be the case of what's depicted in the fossil, with the Rapina mammus actually eating the Cetacosaurus while it was still alive, before both were killed in the volcanic aftermath. So, what can we learn from describing this fossil? Mesozoic mammals are usually depicted as having lived in the shadows of their larger dinosaur contemporaries. But this new fossil convincingly demonstrates that mammals could pose a threat even to near fully grown dinosaurs, albeit smaller species. We expect that the volcanic deposits from the Lujiatun fossil beds in China will continue to yield new evidence of interactions among species otherwise unknown from the rest of the fossil record.